Okay, it don't look too bad. I just wish it was like a little higher, but I think we can roll with this. Let's see. I mean, the plate is, it's gonna be hot because you got this under here. Okay, this is what we go through. Okay, it don't look too bad. What you think, cuz? You like it? You cool with it? We here. Game, baby, we in the game. Y'all know why we here. Let's get it. Cause it'll do. I don't know. I don't know what's going on with my hair, girl. All right, let's go. Yo, what it is and what it do. This is your favorite cousin, and I am back with another banger. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the little bell notification so you can be notified when your favorite cousin posts another video. What we have prepared for us is some good old Jamaican food. I got this from Jamaican Gates in Arlington. I actually did not DoorDash it. I went to get it. I am truly proud. What we have prepared for us is some good old oxtails, some rice and peas, some brown stew chicken, and some Rasta pasta, which looks amazing. The setup ain't the best. I tried to add some color to it, girl. We are here. Before we get into this good old bite, let's go ahead and get into this prayer, cause bow it. God, thank you so much once again for the food that you have prepared before my body, Lord God. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for restoration, Lord God. Thank you for the grace to just keep going. I know things get hard for us sometimes, Lord God, but thank you for just guiding us every step of the way. As for me, no nerves, no anxiety. Continue to do what you're doing in my life, Lord God, because I trust you that much to just let you lead the way. I just want to say thank you. In your name I pray, amen. Now, it's been a long 24 hours. I shall tell you about it. Yeah. I feel good. I feel great. Guess what we fit to do? Oh, let's go ahead and get into this. Boy, that was like a 2-minute intro. Y'all try to add some color to it by adding, you know, the good old boodles, but girl, they for decoration. Let's get it in. Let's start with the rice and peas first. My plate. My plate is like way up there today because I got it on this hot plate, and y'all know I'm clumsy, and so I had to wear like some long sleeve because y'all know I got a habit of burning myself. So let's go ahead and get into this oxtail for the good old little baby. Oh my Lord. Wow, look at the juiciness, cuz. You gotta see this here. I'm trying this up a little bit. Look at that. Look at that summer going. I'm looking at this. My lights aren't even right today. We're gonna roll with it. They tender, they juicy. And that little pepper added a nice touch. Let's get into this Rasta pasta. Come on, I should have bought me a regular spoon. I mean, a regular fork for this. I'm trying to get it in. This wooden fork, knocking my hustle. Get into it. Get into it. Spicy is, oh, it's like so spicy. spicy, but it's like flavorful, like busting with flavors. It's like it's got squash, zucchini, what's that? Tomatoes. It's, man, this is busting. But it's packing a powerful punch in the heat. Mm-hmm. 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 Oh. Y'all. It's so good, but it's so spicy. Oh my Lord, but you can't stop eating it. You can't. No, you cannot. It's got like whole bell peppers in there, some good. Okay, Jamaican Gates. Y'all know back in the day, I've done a Jamaican Gates mukbang before. I've done a Jamaican Gates mukbang before. That was like 2 years ago. But I went to the barbershop today. It sure wasn't to get my hair done, clearly. But I went to the barbershop today and My barbershop was right there by Jamaican Gates. I went to see my friends because I ain't seen them in a while because, you know, I've been gone and stuff. And I was like, oh my God, Jamaican Gates is right there. This Rasta pasta, it's Rastering, you hear me? It's Rastering. My bad. Mm-hmm. It's so spicy, it got my nose running. Like I'm eating good crawfish or something. I ain't got to the stew, actually, I ain't even got to the brown stew chicken yet. Look at this summer going here. I actually got the hot plate on under here because I didn't want my food to get cold today. Look at that, cuz. Get into it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, this is the only place in Fort Worth that I have tried Jamaican food at. And somebody hit me up the other day. I think it was Kim. It was on IG. She hit me up and she was like, yo, Ash, there's so many food spots in Dallas. And she like started giving me like a list of like all the food spots. So we put to get it in. Even if I have to drive to get it. Because you know I'm a DoorDash queen. Do you hear me? I would. But they be checking out my money. So now it's time for me to go get it. Okay. Let's get into this piece of bird here. Oh, it's steaming too. It's falling off the bone. My Lord, look at that, cuz. You see that right now? Let me get into it. Let's see. Hold up, that's a real. Hold on. That was a real, cuz. That's why I did that. It's good, but I did it because that's a whole inevitable. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna keep it a book. I really wasn't just like starving. I really wasn't hungry. I was when I went and got it. But when I got home, I was drinking water. So I just decided to sit down and have a little bite to eat with your cuz, even if I don't eat it all, which I never do. But I should have gotten some more of that Chinese food. I mean, some of the, what I had in the video yesterday. If you have not watched that video, I dropped the sushi mukbang yesterday. YouTube, they playing with me. They doing it. But thank God I don't do this review, so it's all good. But I got this from Jamaican Gates in Arlington. I think it's off 157 and what was that? I forgot what it is. I'm not really starving, but this spot, this spot, it do. We're not gonna be here long. I'm gonna go. I'm gonna do it. Girl, that Rasta pasta done rostered me out of here. It did it. Truly did it. Turn this down, cause well, we done burnt up the house again. You remember the day we used to. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. My lighting on this video. I hope you like the lighting, cuz it ain't looking too good for me, but she pretty. Hey, oh, let's go ahead and get into this conversation. Happy hump day, my love. Happy freaking Wednesday from the bottom of my heart. I was supposed to record this video yesterday, but I had to go get my kid from school early. So when I went and got the food, they called me. I had to go get her. And so I didn't get a chance to record yesterday. I know y'all be like, cuz, oh, come on now with the times. Girl, when you got kids, your whole life just be. Everything, my whole life revolves around Callie's schedule. You know, she it does. Everything that I do revolves around her. So if I gotta go get my baby, and y'all already know how I feel about being a mom. It's one of my greatest pleasures in freaking life is being that kid's mom. So yesterday, we just spent the day together. She played hooky, because when she got home, she was fine and dandy. But it ain't nothing like a mama's love. So I know she was comfortable being in my energy. So I know she felt better. So that's why I didn't get this video recorded anyway yesterday. But the girl is about to be one. Callie will be one on March the 30th. Can you believe it's like been a year already? She's walking. She's talking. Well, she's not talking, but you know what she be saying sometimes. But thank God for blessing me to be a mom. But anyway, long story short, I wanted to tell you this. It's okay to see the good in people as long as it does not affect you being good. I'm gonna say that again. It's okay to see the good in people as long as it doesn't affect you being good. What I mean by that is sometimes people will be wolves in sheep clothing and they'll try to show you that they're good people. And what we do is we try to change how we're good. We try to see through their flaws and just still try to be good to them even though we're being messed over. And then when you get messed over in the end, you're like, damn, I shouldn't have been good to this person. Yes, you should have. Keep being good to people. Don't let how somebody else treats you affect you being good. Stop. Don't stop. I guess what I'm trying to say is, I know I'll be all over the place. I guess what I'm trying to say is, don't stop being a good person. Just change who you're good to. And that doesn't mean you have to treat people badly. That doesn't mean you have to treat them with less respect. But once you know somebody, you know how to deal with them. You know what I'm saying? No, and that's what I love about just me with the spirit of discernment. Yeah, I'm very friendly. I'm nice to everybody. I love everybody. But it just comes to a certain point in your life where you just get so tired of being messed over. So don't stop being good to people. Just change your surroundings and don't allow it for you to. What? Ashley, I know what I'm saying, but I can't get it out today for some reason. Girl, don't stop being good to people just because somebody did you bad. It's the whole thing in a nutshell around here. And I had a reference. I had some, I had two bags of these peppers. I really do like these peppers. Me and Callie eat them with ranch. They're not hot. Bell peppers. But I had two bags of these in my refrigerator. I had a fresh bag, and I had a bag that it wasn't really old, but it was kind of like, all right, Ashley, you pushing it. Don't eat that. So I was looking at the two bags, and I was like, huh, should I use the old one? It ain't that bad. It's not that bad. Follow me. It's not that bad, but I knew it would probably cause harm if I ate them peppers. So what I'm saying is sometimes we try to hold on to things that we know that aren't good for us, and we know these things are going to cause us harm, but we're such loving people that we give people the benefit of the doubt, so we hold on to them. I want you to release that, man. I want you to start releasing people who no longer fit your journey to where you're going. And I'm talking to myself. We talked about this in the Taco Bell video. You got to release people who no longer fit where you're going. If I would have ate them damn peppers, girl, I probably would have been a running mess. I know it's probably a bad example, but I probably would have been a running mess. But I got this old other bag over here that's ready to be good to me. But here I am still holding on to this old bag because I just feel like it's still good when I know it's not. We hold on to things for too long because we see the good in it. When I know those pimples probably, they was just bad. But think about how you got so much old stuff in your refrigerator that you just don't want to clean out. You don't want to get rid of. You don't want to get rid of it because I might need this one day. So you hold on to it. Really easy. Cuz throw that old stuff away. Throw that old stuff away so we can start making room for the new stuff, man. And that's why I am in life, you know. I'm just at that point in life of just tired of being messed over and all of these things. And honestly, messing up with myself. Sometimes I'm not good to myself as I should be. If that light is too close to that and it had that static and sound today, I'm a raw. All right. Oh, girl, I'm fit to fight the light. It's crazy. But be good to yourself, most importantly. I'm not as good to myself as I should be. But here I am just standing in front of this camera just trying to maintain and trying to keep pushing. You know what I'm saying? No, but make sure you being good to yourself. Girl, I don't know what the hell I just said. I know I said it. Lord, send me a sign! I don't know why I yell. But anyway, shout out to my boo, Ray Love. Shout out to my boo, Sincere Team, Tam's Table. Shut the block party down last night. Thank y'all for everybody who celebrated in the celebrate. Because Ray was inserting clips of us that night at Get Lit with Mo House. Man, I tell you what, bro. If y'all not subscribed to Ray Love, Vaughn's Crazy Family, Get Lit with Mo, Rasta, Sincere Team, man, please do yourself a favor and go do so. I love me some Mo. Mo, when I see you. Mo, when I see you. Get Lit with Mo. I'm shooting my shot. Rasta, don't take this personal. I love you. Mo, when I see you, put on that red dress. Woo! And some of them high heels. Come on, Mo. Come sit on my lap, Mo. Come. I love you, Mo. Life is what you make it. Surround yourself around good people with good intentions. And that's one thing I can't say about Get Lit with Mo and the whole gang. Their intentions are so pure. I love it. No clue what this video was about. Never do. I came over here to bump my gums. The moral of that story is, girl, we're just gonna call this a We Heal video. If you understood what I said, because I know my delivery was whack today and I ain't eat nothing, but if you understood what I said, just say cuz I feel you in the comments. Just flood the comments with cuz I feel you. I don't know what the hell this, I really don't know what the hell this video was about. Never do. Anyway. I love you. Stay true to yourself. It's probably wasn't my best video, but you know what? Janice, I love you. Meet and greet ATL, March 19th. We'll set the city on fire. We bring some special friends. I love y'all from the bottom of my heart. Let's get it. It's not on you. Girl, I can't hold on. Let me gather myself. Get yourself together. Watch what somebody gonna say when they see me in this hoodie. It's cold outside, so I got on like 8 layers. Watch when somebody see me in this hoodie. They gonna say, cuz, you done got some white cups. No! Alright. I sometimes just come over here and do what the hell I wanna do, don't know. It's inevitable. This is your favorite cuzzo. Y'all know what it is. You already know what to do, guys. Love me. Don't forget to drink a beer for me. This is my cousin's good. Turn curse. Welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen. I ain't ate a damn thing. I ain't ate nothing. Not nothing. I repeat, I ain't ate nothing. Some mukbang I ain't. Ooh, all right, love you. Cuz, you know, I feel like you deserve better than what I just gave you. We're gonna do better. Somebody told me yesterday that my video lacked qualities. I truly agree sometimes. Let's come on here and do what the hell I wanna do. It was good to see you today. Let's get it.